So what happened is our input looks something like this. You know, I left out the other attributes, no big deal. Our variable month gets substituted into the string. So if month equals November, you know, the string November renders, and we get a text box that looks like this, which is what we'd expect. But if month equals the string foo with a quote in it and an angle bracket and some more text, the string we render ends up looking something like this, where we substitute this variable into here, because the value for month was actually this whole string, including the quote and the angle bracket, which screwed up our HTML. So our browser saw this, and it sees an input and says value equals foo, and then it sees a closing quote and a closing angle bracket, and it gets this other string derp, and it just prints that. So that's obviously not the behavior we want. The rendered HTML ends up looking, you know, or in the browser, ends up looking something like this. You got a text box with the word foo in it, and then it's just a quote and an angle bracket and the string derp just hanging out there, and you know, that's not what we intended. And what's really scary is this allows somebody who knows how our website works to, you know, not just enter random text, but what if they put HTML in our input? What if instead of, you know, derp, it was something, you know, something better? You know, let's look at that in our browser. So we're going to enter our bad data again, and this time we're going to put HTML in there. Okay, so this time I've put in a quote, an angle bracket to close our input tag, and then I've put some HTML, you know, a line break and some bold text. And let's see what happens now. Oh man, we completely broke our form. You know, now we're printing the bold text, oh no, and we've had a line break, and this allows the user to completely manipulate what our document looks like. So that is not something we want to allow. Let's talk about how to fix this.